गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, साई राम, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड हेल्दी एंड स्टेइंग सेफ एट योर प्लेसेस। सो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर फ्रॉम योर इंग्लिश ग्रामर बुक, ओके? फ्रॉम योर इंग्लिश ग्रामर बुक। सो द चैप्टर विच वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टुडे इज degrees of comparison. Degrees of comparison. Now children, do you know the meaning of this word comparison? Do you know? So children, comparison means to compare. Comparison means to compare more than two things. More than two things. If I will say I want to compare this pen, I cannot do that. I cannot do this, do comparison of this pen, okay? Because another pen is not there or another object is not there so that I can compare this. So what if I have one more pen? Now can I do comparison? Now comparison is possible, children? Yes, now comparison is possible. If I would have three pen, then also comparison would be possible. So that means, children, we can compare object or anything if it is more than two. More than two. One thing never compares. Okay, one thing we never compare. And at your home only, children, you all have seen, right? You all are having siblings. So when your mother gives you something to eat or something to, let's consider eat only. So something to eat, children, most of the children are very curious or they want to know that how much my sibling is getting, how much she or he is getting. So you see in their plate also, okay, right? And then you see, oh, if she is having the similar quantity or not. If not, then you start feeling grumpy, right? So what you are doing at that time, children? You are comparing, okay? You are comparing your food with your sibling's food. You're comparing it. So children, comparison means in simple words to compare. Like here, if I will say that this pen is thicker than this. This pen is thicker than this. Now, can you see this comparison, children? This pen is thinnest than this, and this pen is thicker than this. That means this pen is thicker than this pen. So what I am doing here, I'm comparing these two pen. Okay, so I'm comparing these two pen. So comparison means to compare more than two objects. How we compare? We compare characteristics. We compare characteristics, features of any object. Okay, so how much it is similar to each other? How this pen is similar to each other? Or how different it is each other from each other, right? How similar in comparison, children? First, we compare is how similar is these pens are. Okay, how similar the object is, then how different the object is from each other, and to what degree? Okay, so children, now I will show you pictures. Okay, now you can see pictures here, right? Small, smaller, smallest. Small, smaller, smallest. Tall, taller, tallest. Tall, taller, tallest. And then heavy, heavier, heaviest. Heavy, heavier, heaviest. Again, small, smaller, smallest. Tall, taller, tallest. Heavy, heavier, heaviest. Now, what is these, children? In this table, what you can see, children? That all these objects are compared with each others, right? These toffees are getting compared. This boy is getting compared with this, then this. And these bags are getting compared. So what we are doing here? We are doing here comparison. So children, so to go through this chapter, children, first you should know what is adjective. Okay, what is adjective, children? We have studied adjective in our previous video, children. I hope you all remember. So adjective is what, children? Adjective is to describe or to tell the quality of noun or pronoun, right? To tell the quality or to describe the quality of noun or pronoun. Adjective itself tells. Adjective is what, children? Describing word, right? So an adjective of quality, you remember we have studied different kinds of adjectives, and one of them was adjective of quality, right? Adjective of quality, that means describing the or telling the quality of noun or pronoun. So an adjective of quality changes its form when it is used to compare one noun with another. When it is used to compare one noun with another, okay? And it is called the degree of comparison of an adjective. It is called the degree of comparison of an adjective, okay? Now, again, let's see the picture here, children. Okay, four pictures you can see in your screen, right? In first picture, what you can see, children? What name is written here? Hari. An old man. Ramu. Another old man like Hari. Neeraj. More old than Hari and Ramu. Anil. The oldest man from Neeraj, Ramu and Hari. So in first picture, you can see Hari, an old man. In second picture, you can see Ramu, another old man. Third picture, Neeraj, more old, and in the last one, Anil, the oldest man. So here we are comparing these four men. So that means comparison is between these four men. So here in this picture, what you can see is that Hari and Ramu are of similar age group. Okay, they both are old men, and Neeraj is more old than Hari and Ramu, and Anil is the oldest from Hari, Ramu and Neeraj. Okay, so children, I have told you that for comparison we should know that how these two things are similar with each other, how different from each other, and to what degree. So for comparison, children, there are three degrees of comparison. To compare object or noun, we use three degrees of comparison. Okay, positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. Positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. These are the three degrees of comparison. In the basis of these three or degrees of comparison, we do comparison of nouns or pronouns. So the positive degree, the comparative degree and the superlative degree. Okay, so here I have shown you a picture, children, right? So Hari is an old man. Hari is an old man. Okay, then Ramu is as old as Hari. Okay, Ramu is as old as Hari. Like Ramu, another old man, that means Ramu and Hari are of similar age group. Okay, similar age group. Ramu is as old as Hari. Ramu is as old as Hari. Neeraj is older than Hari. Neeraj is older than Hari. And Anil is the oldest man from all the three men. Anil is the oldest man. Okay. So, here three old people are compared with Hari. Three old people are compared with whom? Hari. Okay. Compared with Hari. So, in the first sentence, Hari is an old man. Right. In the first sentence, the first sentence shows that Hari and Ramu are of same age. As I have told you, in the first sentence, what it shows, children, that Hari and Ramu are of same age. Hari and Ramu are of same age. Okay, Hari and Ramu are of same age. Here, the adjective old indicates a positive degree. What it indicates, children? Positive degree. Okay, so first sentence shows that Hari and Ramu are of same age. Okay, and here the adjective old indicates a positive degree. What it indicates? Positive degree. So how do we know that it is a positive degree? So children, when we used to compare two persons, So when we used to compare two person or things of equal rank, we call it a positive degree. Okay, we call it a positive degree. So when we used to compare two persons or things of equal rank, Hari and Ramu are of same age group. Okay, we were comparing Hari and Ramu, but they are of same age group. Their rank is, you can say, equal, right? So when we compare two equal person or things, then it is considered as a positive degree. We call it a positive degree. Okay, now in the second sentence, what was there, children? Second sentence was written here, the adjective older. Okay, now second sentence is here, this one, Neeraj is more old. So in second sentence here, the adjective older, which adjective has used here, children? Older. Okay, which adjective will be used here, children? Older. Which adjective? Older. So here the adjective older indicates a comparative degree. Comparative degree. What it is indicating? Comparative degree. Okay, this adjective older is indicating comparative degree. So here also we are comparing two persons. Okay, two persons are being compared, Neeraj and Hari, but they are not of same rank. In earlier case, Hari and Ramu were of equal rank because they were of same age group. But here, Neeraj and Hari are not of same rank. That means their age group is not same, right? Neeraj is more older than Hari. Okay, Neeraj is more older than Hari. So therefore, when we use adjectives to compare two persons or things of a different rank, we call it a comparative degree. Comparative degree. When we compare adjectives of same rank, right? When we compare adjectives of person or thing of same rank, then it is positive degree. And when we use adjectives to compare two person or things of a different rank, we call it a comparative degree. Okay, now we can like do comparison. Okay, now then third sentence is what, children? Oldest. The adjective oldest, okay, the adjective oldest shows that more than two persons, Hari and Neeraj, more than two persons are compared. It is called as superlative degree. When we compare more than two person, it becomes what, children? It is called as superlative degree. Okay, so this man here, Anil, is the oldest. Okay, oldest man from Hari and Neeraj. Okay, so the adjective oldest shows that more than two persons are compared, and it is called a superlative degree. Superlative degree. So children, these are your three degrees of comparison. Okay, positive degree, comparative degree, superlative degree. Positive degree, when we compare adjective of two person or things of a equal rank. Okay, so children, when we use adjective to compare two person or things of a same rank, it is called positive degree. When we use adjective to compare two person or things of a different rank, it is called as comparative degree. And when we compare more than two persons, okay, when more than two persons are compared, it is called as superlative degree. Superlative degree. Now, children, wait. Okay, now comparatives and superlative degrees are formed. Now, like how comparatives and superlative degrees are formed. Okay, so first, by adding ER. So, children, it is clear, it will be clear to you all more when you will do exercises. Okay, it will be more clear to you all. So, by adding ER and EST, by adding ER and EST to the positive degree, by adding ER, we make what, children? Comparative degree. And adding EST, we make superlative degree to the positive degree. To the positive degree, like old, older, oldest. Old, older, oldest. Now, here you can see example, children. Okay, here you can see, like tall. In this positive degree, we are adding ER, taller. Then it becomes what? Comparative degree. Here we are adding EST, it becomes tallest. We are making what? Superlative degree. Superlative degree. Right? So, by adding ER and EST to the positive degree, okay, by adding R and ST, like able, abler, and ablest. By adding R and ST, like able is positive degree, abler is comparative, adding R, and ablest is superlative, adding ST, okay. Then, by changing the last letter Y into I, by changing the last letter Y into I, and adding ER and EST to positive degree, like easy, easier. Now, here we have changed Y to I, and adding ER at the end, and then easiest. Changing again Y to I and adding EST at the end. Easy, easier, easy, easiest. Okay, then there are some adjectives to which we add more and most to make it comparative and superlative. Okay, like active. Wait. Okay, like active, more active, most active. Now you cannot say active, activer, activist. It will be a wrong. So, to make some words does not need ER or EST at the end. Okay, simply the word will be same as a positive degree. Or the only thing which will change is you will write more or most in front of that word. Okay, if you will write more active, that is a comparative degree. And if you will write most active, that is a superlative degree. So, active, more active, most active. Okay, this is the correct. So, degrees of comparison. You cannot write active, activer, actives, activist. Okay. Okay. So, to some adjectives, we have to add the last letter of the positive degree plus ER and EST to make it comparative and superlative. Example, big, bigger, biggest. Big, bigger, biggest. Now, what we are doing here? We are adding the last letter of the positive degree. Now here we are adding big is the positive one. Then after writing here big, then again adding ER, bigger, and then again adding EST, biggest. Big, bigger, biggest. So these in this form, comparative and super degrees are formed. Okay, now here positive, comparative, and superlative. Only example is there. Okay, as rich as, richer than the richest. That means positive degree, I have told you that positive degree is what, children? When we compare adjectives or adjective of like two person or things of a same rank. That means I will say like राम इज एज रिच एज राहुल. राम इज एज रिच एज राहुल दैट मीन्स राम इज एज रिच एज राहुल दैट मीन्स राम एंड राहुल बोथ आर रिच. सो द रैंक इज सेम. सो दिस डिग्री इज वॉट पॉजिटिव कंपेरेटिव रिचर देन राम. रिचर देन विल बी लाइक नीरज इज रिचर देन राम. नीरज इज रिचर देन राम. देन राहुल इज द रिचेस्ट फ्रॉम राम एंड नीरज. ओके सो एज रिच एज वेन कंपेयरिंग सेम रैंक. ओके कंपेरेटिव इन रिचर देन वेन कंपेयरिंग टू डिफरेंट रैंक एंड द रिचेस्ट वेन कंपेयरिंग मोर देन टू. एज लार्जर देन द लार्जेस्ट. ब्यूटिफुल मोर ब्यूटिफुल मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल सेम. ब्यूटिफुल ब्यूटिफुलर ब्यूटिफुलेस्ट रॉन्ग. ओके यू कैन नॉट राइट दैट. ब्यूटिफुल मोर ब्यूटिफुल मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल. एज यंग एज यंगर देन द यंगेस्ट. ओके नाउ वी विल डू सम एक्सरसाइजेस. ओके चिल्ड्रेन नाउ दिस इज व्हाट शॉर्ट. ओके वेट. सो चिल्ड्रेन व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इज यू हैव टू गिव द कंपैरेटिव एंड सुपरलेटिव डिग्रीज ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एडजेक्टिव्स. ऑल दीज एडजेक्टिव्स आर इन पॉजिटिव डिग्री आर इन पॉजिटिव वेट आर इन पॉजिटिव डिग्री. ओके पॉजिटिव डिग्री. यू हैव टू गिव कंपैरेटिव डिग्री एंड सुपरलेटिव डिग्री ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एडजेक्टिव्स. ओके सो शॉर्ट व्हाट विल बी द कंपैरेटिव ऑफ शॉर्ट चिल्ड्रन. शॉर्टर व्हाट विल बी द कंपैरेटिव डिग्री. शॉर्टर SHORTER शॉर्टर. एंड व्हाट विल बी द सुपरलेटिव डिग्री. Shortest. What will be the superlative degree? Shortest. 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 Okay. Next, weak. Weak. What will be the comparative of weak children? Weaker. Okay. What will be the comparative? Weaker. 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 And what will be the superlative? Weakest. WEAKEST weakest. Okay weakest. Then next is wise. What will be the comparative degree of wise? Wiser. WISER wiser. And what will be the superlative degree? Wisest. What will be the superlative degree? Wisest. WISEST wisest. Then fat. What will be the comparative? Fatter. What will be the comparative? Fatter. Comparative degree of fat will be fatter. And what will be the superlative degree? Fattest. Fattest. Okay. FATTEST. Fattest. Then happy. Comparative degree of happy will be happier. 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 What will be the comparative degree? Happier. And superlative happiest. HAPPIEST happiest. Okay then comparative degree of beautiful we have done more beautiful and superlative will be most beautiful. Okay now comparative degree of much. What will be the comparative degree of much children? Mucher. And superlative will be muchest. Is it correct? No. Comparative degree of much is more. Okay more. And superlative will be most. Much more most. Then bad. What will be the comparative degree of bad children? Comparative degree of bad. So children what will be the comparative and superlative degree of bad? Badder baddest. No. The comparative of comparative degree of bad will be worse. WORSE worse. Okay. And superlative degree will be worst. WOREST worst. Okay. short, shorter, shortest, weak, weaker, weakest, wise, wiser, wisest, fat, fatter, fattest, happy, happier, happiest, beautiful, more beautiful, most beautiful, much, more, most, bad, worse, worst. Okay, now in this, you have to underline and name the degree of comparison. First, you have to underline the name of degree, and then you have to write that which degree of comparison it is. So, first sentence, Rekha is more beautiful than her sister. Rekha is more beautiful than her sister. Now, here, more beautiful. Which degree of comparison? Which degree of comparison? Comparative degree. Because positive degree is beautiful, comparative degree is more beautiful, and superlative degree is most beautiful. Most beautiful. Okay, now honesty is the best policy. Honesty is the best policy. Now here, best. Best. Best is what, children? Best is what, children? Best is superlative degree. Superlative degree. Now, what will be the comparative positive degree of best? Good. Good. And comparative degree will be better. Okay. Good, better, best. Now, next is Ramu is kind master. Ramu is kind master. Now, kind master. Kind. Kind is what, children? Positive degree. Kind is what, children? Positive degree. What will be the comparative and superlative of kind? Kind, kinder, kindest. Okay. Next, it was the sweetest song. It was the sweetest song. Which degree? Superlative degree. Superlative degree. And what will be the comparative and positive and comparative degree of sweetest? Positive degree will be sweet. And comparative degree will be sweeter. And superlative degree is sweetest. Okay. So, children, this exercise which we have discussed here, you do not need to do it in your notebook. Okay. For a practice, you can do it in your rough notebook. But not need to do it in your fair notebook. Because this work will be done in your grammar book. So, children, I will share PDF. Okay, I will share PDF, and from that PDF, you note it down in your grammar book. And if you can even try by yourself, children, but I will provide PDF. Okay, so no need to do this work in your fair notebook. For a practice, you can do it in rough, but no need to do it in fair one. Okay, so children, I hope this degree of comparison, chapter 6 degrees of comparison, is clear to you all now. So we have three degrees of comparison: positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. Positive degree is used when we describe same rank. Okay, two person or things of same rank. And comparative degree, when we describe two person or things of different rank. And superlative degree, when we compare more than two person, that is superlative degree. Okay, so children, I hope this chapter is clear to you all, and you can go through the video again. Sairam.